Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, dear friends of the Wilfried Martin Center for European Studies. The pandemic has forced us to change our habits and acquire new skills. But I am glad that COVID-19 had neither paralyzed us nor discouraged us from organizing traditional events that proved their worth in the past. Traditions and continuity in good, belong to our way of life. This is why I am very pleased that I can launch the fifth edition of our Net at Work event. I want to welcome you all, the active participants, panelists and speakers, but also all followers. Allow me to thank three Martin Center's member foundations that organize and co-sponsor the event together with us, the Martin Center. It is Konrad Adenauer Stiftung, its European office in Brussels. It is Politische Academy from Austria, and it is also Hans Seidel Stiftung. From our Martin Center side, I want to thank Anna Nalivaiko, the mastermind of the event, and also Jamil Kitone, the technical mind of our webinars and online conferences. I want separately thank those member foundations that have decided to participate actively with their particular panel discussion. Usually we, the Martin Center and other European foundations, are dealing with the greatest, more or less global challenges and the hottest topical European issues. But I know very well that for every human being, the hottest issue is this one who burns him or her the most. This is the reason why we wanted to bring also regional and national challenges, emphases, or priorities to Brussels, or, as it happens in these times, to common virtual table. And I am very happy that it happens. Dear friends, we have 8 panels in 2 days. We start with Anton Tunega Foundation from Slovakia and the topic, Current Challenges to Religious Freedom. Then continue with Konrad Adenauer Stiftung and Political Academy with the title, Staying Subsidiarity, Getting Stronger. The third panel will be chaired by Konstantin Karamanlis Institute from Greece and will be devoted to digital transformation as a geopolitical challenge for Europe. And we will finish today with Hans Seidel Stiftung and Luigi Sturzo Institute from Italy and migration. More specifically, with the new European Pact on Migration. Closing remarks will be made by Markus Ferber, member of the European Parliament and the president of the Hans Seidel Stiftung. Tomorrow, we start with the opening remarks of Dr. Hardy Ostri, the head of the European Konrad Adenauer Stiftung office in Brussels, and the panel devoted to the geopolitical challenges of the Eastern Mediterranean and the EU-Turkey relation. The panel is organized by the Glafkos Klerides Institute from Cyprus. Then we continue with De Gasperi Foundation, Italy, and team A Europe That Protects Its Heritage. After that, we will, together with CDA Research Institute, and discuss about the Green Deal, and the final panel will be devoted to the future EU enlargement and the Western Balkan region. The panel, the last panel, has been prepared by the Freedom and Democracy Foundation from Albania. And the closing remarks will be made by Bettina Rausch the president of the Politische Academy. Dear friends, I wish us all very, very inspiring debates. And now I'd like to pass the floor to Miriam Lexman, member of the European Parliament and the moderator of our first panel. Dear Miriam, ahoy, the floor is yours.